of new enterprises and job creation. So bioprospecting is the search and the discovery of useful and new genes or compounds or bacteria from biological resources. In the specific case of microbial associated genes and compounds, in the last few years there have been huge advances in the microbial ecology field. And these advances, which include improved culturing, sampling, or bioinformatic techniques, have led to a discovery of a very large amount of bacterial diversity. It's estimated that there is more than 1 trillion microbial species on Earth. So you can get an idea of what amount of diversity this is, we have done a simple calculation. Imagine that the genome of each species could fit on 1 A4 sheet of paper. If we piled up all these sheets of paper, one for each species, the pile would be 100,000 kilometers high, which is more or less about a quarter of the distance from the Earth to the Moon. And now imagine all the useful things that we can get from this microbial diversity. Searching natural environments for useful things, or bioprospecting, isn't something new. For example, the soil is a rich source of microorganisms able to produce antibiotics, or we can find a very large amount of probiotic bacteria in the human gut. These environments are quite well known, and there have been many previous bioprospecting studies that have been focusing on them, but there are many other environments that remain unexplored. For example, unusual environments that are distant from human-associated microbiomes and that are under extreme conditions. And these unusual environments are especially interesting for 3 reasons. First of all, seeing as they are not very well known, there's a high probability of finding new microorganisms. Second, the microorganisms that are able to live in these environments are pre-adapted and have developed natural ways to resist environmental stress. And these adaptations can be especially interesting for industrial applications. For example, sun-exposed environments like solar panels are rich in carotenoid-producing bacteria. And carotenoids are pigments with important applications in the food, cosmetic, and pharmacological industries. Third of all, these resistant microbes can be very robust and they can be useful as biofactories. The study of unusual environments has led to the discovery of some very interesting products like biofuel from archaea that live in deep sea hydrothermal vent chimneys or latex degrading bacteria that live in pine trees. But there are still many unexplored environments with interesting microorganisms that are waiting to be discovered with the right sampling and culturing techniques. And this is not only interesting from the scientific point of view, but it's also a great opportunity for the market of the biotechnological industry. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you've enjoyed it. As always, I have left the link to the paper in the description, and you can find subtitles in English and in Spanish. If you have really liked this video, please give me a thumbs up, comment, or subscribe to my channel, and I will see you next week.